Well, I'll just give a little word of quick introduction. First of all, thank you all for coming again and being a part of our Wednesday night, our just little fellowship tonight. And I just wanted to introduce again to you Alice Bayless, and she's going to speak in a moment. We have a few people speaking each week during these 5-6 weeks of our Lent season on a devotional that was significant during this specific week. And so again, thank you, Alice, for sharing tonight. And if you haven't already, Alice, I'll have you unmute your microphone. I'm going to ask you just to have a little conversation with you as we get started so I can see you're unmuted. There we go. But if I understand right, let's see, you and your family. So Alice, husband, Joe, children, Brock and Graham, you guys have been here at Community of Hope maybe around 12 years. Is that accurate?
It was actually before Brock was born, and he's 13. So I think it's been about 15 years.
Wow.
Can't believe it.
Wonderful.
Probably members for 12.
Okay. Yeah. You've been attending for even up to 15 years. Wow. That's great. That's great. And one other kind of...
I don't look that old, do I? I mean...
Not at all. but a couple other fun facts. You have a twin sister, Amelia, and family, her husband, Chris, and then their kids, Macy and Reed, also have been a part of Community of Hope for many years. So, and I see your mom attending too. She's been lately coming in the parking lot oftentimes for worship and that. So you got a real family connection here.
Yes. Yeah, we do. It's been great. Great through the
years. It's neat. So it's great to have you guys on board and the kids involved. And one other kind of cool thing, I think I shared last week that Ted and I were at Pacific Lutheran University around the same time. And actually, your husband, Joe, and I, we attended R.A. Long High School in Longview, Washington, not at the same time. I'm a couple years older, maybe more than a couple, but it's kind of interesting that we both went to the same high school in Longview, Washington. And in fact, I think his baseball coach was a classmate of mine, Rich Reeves, who's now the principal at the high school. And so it's been fun to share some Longview memories and high school memories, but pretty amazing. All the different degrees of separation, you know, bring us all pretty close every once in a while when we think about it and talk with each other.
Yeah.
So, but yeah, that's cool. But Alice, just again, thank you for sharing tonight. And you chose a devotional from the past week that kind of spoke to your heart. And yeah, if you wouldn't mind maybe just reading the Bible passage and then sharing a little bit about the devotional. And I think it was from Friday, February 26th, right? The title is Vulnerable. So if you have your devotionals, if you don't have them already, they are on our website. You can download them, or hopefully you've maybe even gotten a hard copy from church. But anyway, I'll let you take it from here, Alice. Anything that you'd like to share, perhaps even just reading that scripture and starting.
Definitely. Yes. Yeah. And before I jump into that, I did also have spaghetti tonight for dinner. So it sounds like it's quite the pasta pizza evening. So Devin,
yeah, we did pasta too. It was pasta night at Fossil's house.
Yes, it must be a thing.
Okay.
Yeah. So if you have your devotional book, page 10, and can you guys hear me? Can everybody hear me okay? Yes. Okay. So page 10, you can follow along with me, but this one just spoke to me this week. I'll read the beginning of the passage here and kind of set the context. And he called the 12 and began to send them out two by two and gave them authority over the unclean spirits. He charged them to take nothing for their journey except for a staff in their belts, but to wear sandals and not put on two tunics. So they went out and proclaimed that people should repent. And they cast out many demons and anointed with oil many who were sick and healed them. Mark 6, 7 through 9, 12 through 13. And I had to look that up to go, what in the world, what would put on two tunics mean? And I'm sure Pastor John might have better context, but one of the interpretations said it might mean like a change of clothes, like to not bring, you know, to not put on, you know, to only wear the clothes that are on your back and not necessarily close for the next day, but that one stuck out at me is, what does that mean? But the point here is that Jesus asked his disciples, they were in Nazareth, and I think this was their first mission trip without Jesus. So he asked them to go out and to basically preach the good news without a lot of preparation and without a lot of things with them, except for basically a staff and some sandals. So I questioned that, and I looked down at the reflection and the, you know, the questions. And the first question that is asked is, have you ever forgotten to pack something that you really needed, or maybe that you thought you really needed? So I have a funny story to share. It has nothing to do with spreading the good news, but it came to mind for me of something that I didn't forget to pack, but I forgot to do on a trip or to get ready for a trip. So I used to work at Intel in the marketing department, and did for quite a few years. And at this time, this was probably 20 years ago, I was in charge of events for my group. It was a server division, and we were supposed to take down to San Francisco the demos and all the people that would go down to train for Intel and to talk about all the latest server technology that was available. And so I was in charge for our group, for our division, of getting everybody down to the event and making sure that everyone had plane tickets and that all of our demo equipment was down there, and everyone had hotel rooms. And so we flew down and made sure everything was shipped in advance and everybody was prepped and ready. And for those of you who do know me, I am quite the preparer, the planner. Everything has to be organized. If I'm not prepared, I feel very, very unsettled. So I made sure everything was just so. And we got down to San Francisco for the event, and I was making sure everybody was checked in. And so I get down to myself at the front desk and said my name, and they said, we don't have a room for Alice Bayless. And what I realized is I was so worried about planning and preparing the event for everybody else, I forgot to book myself a hotel room down in San Francisco. And anybody who's been to those large corporate events knows that there aren't a lot of spare rooms that would be available if you forget to book yourself a hotel room. So luckily I had a female coworker who was gracious enough to let me stay in the hotel room at least for one night with her. But that's just a funny story that it kind of reminded me of, have I ever really felt unprepared or, you know, forgotten something that I should have had with me? And I think as you go deeper into being vulnerable, and I definitely felt vulnerable that day and kind of foolish as well. But I think I reflected on this more in terms of, in the past year, I would be hard pressed to say any of us haven't felt extremely vulnerable. Not only with COVID and being concerned about our own, health and vulnerable around sickness and death and having all of the pleasures and luxuries kind of stripped away from us this year, not only from a pandemic standpoint, but then you look at, you know, the unrest in Portland, and are we safe on our streets? Even with the forest fires and, you know, not knowing necessarily if we were going to be in our homes, depending on where you lived, and not having clean air to breathe. And also just even the snowstorm a couple weeks ago when we were stripped of electricity and of power, and of heat and of cooking. And so I think it just reminds me of how vulnerable I know I have felt over this past year, and how we have to remember that, God is still sending us into situations, even if we're kind of stripped clean of all the things that we, you know, are used to and some of the comforts that we take for granted. And so in that vulnerability, I think he was telling his disciples to, you know, to travel light. And if you travel light, it forces you to stay dependent on God and to trust God in those situations. So that's really where I see that, you know, he's still sending us out to spread the good news and to do his work, despite feeling, you know, untrained or afraid or confused. We could be terribly vulnerable. And I know I felt really vulnerable this past year, but he has still showed me places where I needed to be spreading his word and doing things, you know, for him, whether that's taking a meal to a neighbor at Christmas time, to, you know, helping family members, to inviting someone to church, which was really challenging. challenging this year because of COVID, but, you know, to be able to encourage them that, hey, you want to try church out? Why don't you just, you know, you can just drive up to church service and listen to it on the radio. But it's just, it was a reminder to me that he doesn't always give us all of the tools and the preparation that we might need, but he still presents opportunities where we need to be there, and he will give us what we need and just what we need. Maybe not everything we think we need, but he will give us exactly what we need to be in the right place at the right time and to help spread his word. So that's, I'd love to open it up, Pastor John, too, to anybody else who maybe has been in a situation where God is sending them to do something and they didn't feel prepared, or if they felt vulnerable this past year. But that's kind of what I really liked about this passage this week.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Alice. And I appreciate that. And again, absolutely invite you, either if you feel like speaking a word, or if you feel like typing in the chat section, something about your experience. But no, it's a good reflection. And thank you for your honesty. I know it's not always easy to share ways that we've, dropped the ball. Like, I forgot to book a hotel room even for me at that. But appreciate your vulnerability to share from your heart. And what was the one other just question, just more on the surface, but not really. I mean, I guess was, when did you guys feel as a family the most vulnerable, even in this past year? Was it the time of the fires? I know we talked about that. Or was it the ice storm? Was it other things? When was it that you guys really felt, oh boy, it's God, let's hold us close and lead us through because we don't know what's going on? Was there any specific time even in this past year you guys have been?
Yeah, I think for sure when we all shut down for COVID and we, you know, school closed and my husband came home and was working from home, it just puts you on a very confused, scared, you know, afraid and vulnerable time. So I think COVID and then piled on top of that, right, were all the other things that we just kept going, yeah. Gosh, how did your year get any more challenging? And so that, the forest fires and the other instances kind of compounded on right. Just the initial COVID scare and being afraid of your health and not being able to see grandparents and not being able to right. do the things that we're so used to doing and that we've kind of taken for granted, right? Yeah.
Yeah. No, it's a great, just this year has been, I know for all of us, that kind of challenging time. And as you look back, and I hope we do have chances to pause and look back and say, God, you have been faithful, even in the midst of all these ups and downs. I know we see that as a church, God's continued to guide us together and to do creative things, but as individuals too, to see how, Lord, at the end of the day, at the end of the year, at the end of the season, whatever you want to say, we can say, God, you're good and you're faithful, no matter what may come. And, but it's hard. Not all of us, I think, like you said, Alice, we want to be in control. I don't think there's one person that just likes, fly by the seat of your pants all the time. Some people are more like that. Right. but at the end of the
not me.
Day, not you. Okay. But there's a certain level where being out of control, it ain't good. And, that's just a human nature, I think, whatever degree you might be at. And I'm amazed as I think about that passage that you read, the faith that these disciples put, okay, we'll go, Jesus. And the Lord equipped them. It says they cast out many demons and anointed with oil many who were sick and healed them. And even when they had nothing, they had everything because they had Jesus. And he was faithful. And so, wow, just good reflections. And I love the real story of real life. And and even a good friend, hey, no problem, you can room with me, hang in there. So it works out. But we got to trust that right now, even that, God's going to be faithful no matter what. So